All right, lads. So it all comes down to this. This is the end of season live com. I'll first be live comming the penultimate game against a team whose name I haven't quite perfected the pronunciation of yet. I'm just going to show you the two games that we've played since our first leg loss to Olympiakos, and it's gone terribly wrong. Both the two games that I'll show you have been defeats, and they've been defeats against opposition we should be getting 3 points from. So we've definitely suffered from a bit of burnout, which is a theme I think in a lot of the seasons that I've managed over, and that's something I'm going to need to look at and try and address for next season. We lost 1-0 to Kakaira away from home. We were completely taken out. Markovsky getting a goal on 73 minutes. Couldn't complain, we didn't deserve to get anything. The performance was very poor. An incredibly wasteful performance against Atromitos, decided by a penalty this match. We had 18 shots, but just two on target. That goes to show you the level of finishing that we have trained all season to achieve here at AEK Athens. It was probably one of the worst performances of the season. And look at that, six players were booked. Two of those bookings have resulted in suspensions for this game, and they are to key players. Kola Vestios, the first choice centre back, and Kevin Conboy, the first choice left back. So those are big holes to fill in the team. In terms of the table, we are sitting in fifth now. Unsurprisingly, we were overtaken by PAOK. Fifth place is the place we need to finish to achieve our aims here. So we just need to keep ahead of Platanias and Panaitolikos, who crucially are our two opponents for the last two games. So we really need to buck up our ideas if we are to avoid finishing in a mediocre position this season. Panathinaikos leading the table by just one solitary point with two games to go. Olympiakos have a far superior goal difference. So you'd think that Panathinaikos would need to beat Olympiakos on points. Tripolis have a slight mathematical chance of winning the league, but it's pretty much certain that they're not going to win. They look dead certain to finish third at the moment. We are going to be battling with PAOK, I think, for fourth potentially. We need to make sure the teams that are behind us currently stay there at the end of the season. In terms of the battle at the bottom, I think OFI Crete, well, they're not quite mathematically relegated, but they need to win their next two games to stand any chance. Hope Atromitos, who beat us last, so they're in good form, also slip up. So it's a tall order for sure. Panionios also have a slight chance of being relegated, so they're going to need to watch out. I'm going to go into the game then. As you can see there, Kulvestios and Conboy are not available for this game. Zizinho and Brecevic are injured. Helder Barbosa is coming back from an injury, so I'm not sure whether we'll risk him for this game. No, we won't. We'll leave him on the bench. He'll probably come on at the hour mark. Anistis, Rapper, Cielis, Saris, and Bakakis is our back line, with Rovas protecting, Grontis and Cordero in midfield, Vitelas and Tunis on the wings, and Aravidis up front. So we've got some of our attacking talent injury free and suspension free, but the back line is seriously been impacted by these suspensions. But we need to get points now. Show us what you can do, lads. It's been three defeats on the spin. That's not good enough for a team of this caliber. Let's get back to winning ways then. We kick off against Panaitolikos. I'll never know for sure how to fluently pronounce their name. But Panaitolikos seem to had the lion's share of the shots, but Grontis delivers a free kick that's straight at the goalkeeper. I think that's our first shot on goal of the game. Villafana's now looking to run at the flank. We're crowding him, but he's still going, and he can deliver a cross, and it's flicked on and into the net for 1-0. Could you be witnessing the games in which my season unravels. Look, we're down to 7th. Could you be watching the end of a season? Was it a good idea to do an end of season live comp? We shall see. We can still get back in the game, but we've not been in it at all so far. And we could be looking at a 4th straight defeat. It doesn't matter how we get this victory, but we definitely need it. Especially ahead of this cup tie in midweek. It would be crucial. Arvidas! 1-1! And we're back in it. Whether we deserve to or not, Arvidas has poked it home. And it's 1-1. We can always trust Arvidas to get us back into a game. He is the captain. He is leading the line. And he's led by example there to put us back in contention. And now Rapper to Patelas. Oh, hits the post. This is a good spell now for us. We need to capitalise on these chances. Corbos now. Godoy. And they're going to launch an attack themselves. Kapil, he's hit the bar. Saris deals with it well. And now Antunes can maybe launch an attack if the ball was of any quality, which it wasn't, unfortunately. And it looks like we're heading into the break level. Just a few minutes of the first half to go. And, yep. Got to be happy with the performance. You've got to be positive to these players when they're on a bad run. I'm going to tell them they're unlucky. Okay. They're motivated. Some of them, anyway. Some of them just don't care whether we finish in a European contention place. Now, Panaitolikos will kick off here. Martinez. Don't concede. Please don't concede. Jesus Christ. That was such a good chance. A draw isn't really good enough at this stage. We need to be beating these teams around us to make sure that we get the spot in the table that we need. Martinez now can launch an attack for Panaitolikos. There's Villafanes, Rapa with a good tackle, but Martinez finds Medaguila, who's on the wing. Oh, what a clearance that is from Bakakis. Just deals with the danger emphatically, but it's not over yet because they have the ball. It's Martinez. It's Ferreira. What can he do here? He's surely going to cut inside. Yeah, it's a corner. That should hopefully be the end of the play, unless something comes from this corner. Something can still come from this corner. It's a long highlight. That should do it. Come on, boys. Let's get back in this. It's Kevin. It's Martinez. They're all over us. They've kept possession so well. Martinez, don't give him that space. He's good at those long shots. Can Arvidas reach that? Yes, he can. He needs to hold it up and wait for the runners and not get tackled, crucially. Cordero gets there. Medaguila intercepts. But Grontis finds Patelas, and the highlight just ends abruptly as I start to get excited. But it's an hour, so we should be looking at our substitutions. Anyone dead? Can't really sub any defenders because there aren't really any. I don't really have a right winger either. Platelas can play there. So I'll bring Helder Barbosa on. A bit of pace. And Klaas Milner can come on for Grontis. A bit of quality in the midfield. Let's bring our big guns out and see what happens. Kakis to Platelas. Now Klaas Milner. He's just going to hold it up. Cordero. He's going to get tackled there. No, he isn't. He's going to deliver a ball to Bakakis. It's Platelas. Oh, surely Barbosa scores. Yes, he does. It's 2-1. Super sub Helder Barbosa. Gives us what could be a crucial win in the race for European contention. Come on, boys. Oh, OFI Crete are getting smashed. I think that result will confirm their relegation, unfortunately for them. They could have done with beating Platanias as well for our sake, because we're contesting them for a top 5 place. Arvidas, can he seal it? Yes, he does. Get in there, my son. It's 3-1. We've got a convincing win here. And the boys have responded very well to that poor run of form. We've got some momentum that we can take into this Olympiakos game now. Crucial momentum. Klaas Milner to Platelas. Cordero Nas Milner to Helder Barbosa. That's a foul. What will the ref do here? He's given a free kick. And he's sent him off. Okay. Unlucky to him. It won't change the game now, though. We're 3-1 up. Oh, what's he going to do with this free kick? Oh, Lamia are 2-0 down as well. They're right down there in the relegation fight. Platelas with the free kick. Straight to the keeper. Doesn't really matter. There it is. It's a 3-1 win. Finally, we get some momentum back at a crucial time of the season. I'm more than happy with that. Let's have a look at the table then. And at the top, Olympiakos have overtaken Panathinaikos to put themselves in the driving seat. What happened to Panathinaikos? They were beaten by PAOK. Our rivals for fourth, so not great for them. I think if the playoffs work in the same way as the playoffs in England for promotion, then we'll play Panathinaikos if we finish fifth. I'd like to avoid that and play Tripolis instead to give us a better chance of reaching the final. But it's unlikely. We need to win and PAOK to lose. So, and we're playing the team directly below us, so we need to not get beat ourselves in that game. Anyway, we've done half the hard work in terms of the domestic season. We need to bring it home now against Platanias. Alright guys, here we are for the Olympiakos game. Part 2 of our end of season live com. Let's see who we have at our disposal here. Good news is that Convoy and Kolaviestos are back from suspension and have had a nice rest away from the game while they think about what they have done. I'll take a risk with his match fitness and put Darko Zoric on just for his quality. He's likely to get injured, but this is a big game and we need our best players playing. Anyway, this is the team. Anistis, Convoy, Cielis, Kolaviestos, Bakakis, Cordero, Klansmuller, Zoric, Helder Barbosa, Antunis and Aravidis. Let's go into the game. Let's ask them to seek revenge here. We need to get them so hyped that they may as well be on ecstasy if we're to get anything from this game. We left ourselves seriously disadvantaged. Yeah, we're 4-2 down from the first leg. So a 2-0 win would do nicely on away goals. But we're not going to get a clean sheet, are we? But Zoric has banged in a free kick to give us the best possible starter here. We're carrying on that momentum from the last game. But I don't think we'll get another anytime soon. We will have to fight every ball and be on our game 100% to go through here. But what a sweet, sweet win it would be. Of course, we still need another goal. We're holding Olympiakos back very well here. It's a very dull game. 3 shots in the entire game. We have the only one on target. Get on that hype. Cielis launches it forward. Siovas to Roberto. Wachiklaklis, however the fuck you say his name. Guidetti, he's dangerous. So's Dokal. Convoy deals with him though. It's Barbosa. It's Zoric. It's Knas Milner. To Cordero, to Zoric. Barbosa will play with them on the left wing. Knas Milner. Aravidis, not going to be so easy to break them down. It's Antunis! It's straight at the keeper. Does Aravidis get there? No. Kolovos should get that away. That was a chance, but the fact that we're creating chances against Olympiakos bodes very well indeed. Come on, boys. Genuinely excited now. There is a chance that we could be going to the Greek Cup final, but it's still a slim chance. Let's keep our feet on the ground. If we concede, we need to score 2 more. Let's just remember that. Barbosa whips it in. It's Aravidis. It's Bakakis. Is Barbosa offside? No, I don't think he is. But he does get tackled, so it doesn't matter anyway. Let's not have Olympiakos launch a clutch little counter-attack. Zoric has it in the middle. Antunis to Bakakis. Can he whip it in? Can anyone? No. It's got pinched. And now, where's the attack here? Oh, is it here? Is it going to be... Are we going to get Guidetti'd again? No, it's straight at the keeper. That is a fat little first half. Pleased, lads. I'm pleased. Shows that we can trust the tactics here. There's no need to keep switching things around. We've got the setup. We might not have the players, but we've got them set up perfectly to try and get something from this semi-final. If nothing else, if it stays like this, we would have won an Athens derby. Not strictly speaking, but we would have beat them over 90 minutes for once. You know, we're still in their shadow, but we've got something to cling on to. Olympiakos have played really badly. Let's wait until after this highlight to make the tactical switch. This could be the highlight. Klaas-Müller! Yes! Get in! It's Klaas-Müller! It's 2-0! And we are going through on away goals. If the away goals rule actually applies. I think it does. I hope so. Really was an idiotic move on my part not to check that out. But Zoric is dead. He's made his contribution for sure. With that wonderful free kick. Helder Barbosa looks a bit tired, so I'm going to bring on Platelas to give us more energy and dynamism on the wing. It's all a case of holding out now. I'm bringing on Eric Abidal, but luckily Guidetti is coming off. Olympiakos haven't played very well. I think what they're doing is... Oh, Antunes is injured. Fuck. I think I actually saved my substitution that time. I think Olympiakos must be resting players for their title push. Which is brilliant news for us. They must have thought they had the game in the bag, and I couldn't blame them for thinking that. Because I thought that too. Oh dear. Oh, sugar. No. 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 And I can't make another substitution. Why would you do that? Oh my good God. How are we going to hold on now? Stupidly got himself sent off. I need to think about this. I need to push someone back. But none of these attacking players can play defence at all competently. Cordero can be a defensive midfielder, I guess. I'm not sure that it's going to play him as a deep line playmaker. Maybe. This is the best I can do, I think. Switch those to defend. I'm unsure about this. But Olympiakos are going to fancy their chances here. And I don't see a way we can hold on. We're just going to have to be lucky. It's that simple. We need to be lucky. Forgot to switch to defensive. That could have been costly. I'm really pissed if it goes to extra time. And there's no away goals rule. Well, so it all rests on whether there's an away goals rule. And there is no away goals rule. So we are screwed, basically. Keep going out there, lads. We're holding on for penalties. This is just like the Champions League final, really. Apart from there's no sending off, you stupid prick. Anyway, we've got to hold on with 10 men against Olympiakos for half an hour. I'd be very impressed if we could do this and just sneak it on penalties. I just don't see a way we can do it. It would help if we got a goal from this highlight, however unlikely that seems. But no, I guess it was pretty unlikely, wasn't it? Goal kicks launched up. Can Cordero get there? Well, he can assist Oletan. And now Damari's found some space. What? Cordero's left. Aravidis, just hold it up, mate, for God's sake. Just hold it up. Waste some time. Mantelos to Klaas-Müller. It's encouraging that Olympiakos haven't managed to do anything with these minutes that they have. Mantelos to Grontis. It's a penalty! Yes! Breathing space! Come on! Oh, palms are sweaty here. I think it's Aravidis who's going to take it. I'm taking a deep breath as... Yes, he's got the rebound! Yes! Come on! Yes! 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 This is amazing. What a comeback. Holy crap, I've shat myself. Big 15 minutes now. 10 minutes to hold on. 5 minutes. Corner for Olympiakos. Well dealt with. Grimaldo. Oh, there's a scramble. No! Oh! We held on for so long. That's heartbreaking. It's going to go to penalties. Oh, don't score again from open play. That would kill me. That would be the end. I think my silence speaks volumes. That is heartbreaking. Maybe if we'd have had 10 players on the fucking pitch, we'd have had a chance. But we've just given our hearts and everything into that game. No, there's no justice. I'm going to have quite a long cry. I'll see you for the last game of the league in a bit, lads. Alright, we're calm. We're cool. We are collected. Heartbroken, but cool, calm and collected. With the sole purpose of getting fourth place in this division. I'm going to bring on Darko. Actually, I'll bring on Darko for Gerontis. There's not too much we can change about the team. Not too many options. Higher tempo. Alright. I'm still in shock. I mean, I'm literally playing this three continues after the defeat, and I don't really think I can think straight right now. Convoy is suspended again. Let's not get hung up on that, though. We have got a league to finish in a decent position in. We're away here. Do we have push higher up on... we need a higher tempo, mate. That's what we need. Bakakis, Platelas. Let's end this on a high. Come on. Let's banish those demons. Barbosa, it's 1-0. Come on. That's the perfect start. And we're up to fourth as PAOK are obviously losing. Or they're just not playing at the same time as us. But a highlight straight from kickoff. That's never encouraging. Unless we have the ball, which we do. Helder Barbosa running down the left flank. Finds Mantelos, it's 2! Come on! So far we've got the more favourable 4th position, which might see us take on a Tripolis in the playoff. I'm still not very sure how the playoff actually works. Barbosa now, running down the left flank again. Platelas, this time the keeper saves. And 3 very, very good chances in 7 minutes, 2 of which have led to AEK goals. That is a brilliant start. Against a team I would have been worrying about under normal circumstances. But I think we're in good form. We've been playing well. Aravidis makes it 3. This is a wonderful performance. Got to admire the lads after that heartbreaking, soul-crushing defeat in the last game. 3-0 up in 15 minutes. That's commendable. Now we have another chance with Platelas. He's running at them. He's hit the post. Unlucky. Teta will get that away. Oh shit, PAOK have taken the lead against Ogotelis. We need PAOK to lose, but it's not too likely, really. But we can only do our best. And we're doing our best at the moment, let's be honest. A very, very complete performance so far. Berrian intercepts that, but by the same token, I think that's Zoric, number 20, intercepts. Oh dear. Torres is onside and through on goal, and he's completely messed his team's best chance of the game. Cordero now finding Rapper on the left flank. It's Zoric to Cordero. And that's intercepted, and Torres will get it back. And they're starting to attack us a bit more now. But we've competently dealt with it so far. Shehu, oh no, Torres gets it. They're playing very direct football. Torres is getting a lot of opportunities at goal. but he's not really taking them so far. It's David Torres, that's his name. Barbosa's picked up a knock. Let's err on the side of caution here. We've got some playoffs to win. Yeah, that substitution has been confirmed, and that is a very pleasing performance, isn't it? The performance has been excellent. Helder Barbosa seems confused and demotivated. What's wrong with you? Anyway, ignoring that, PAOK have taken a 2-0 lead, so it's not likely that we'll get fourth, unfortunately. All that's left to do is see this game out. Right, we'll need to rest Zoric for the big game, I think. The big games. Cordero can go in the deep line playmaker defend role, and that should do. This should be an uneventful second half if everything goes to plan. We're not likely to be too intense like we were in the first 15 minutes. It's hard to be so intense when you're already 3-0 up. Platelas is now cutting inside, and that's a poor shot, but it was under pressure. And attack maybe could be launched by Platanitas here. Teta has it in the middle. It's now Fontas to Garcia. Aguilera. Cristina Aguilera is playing for Platanitas. I guess that's part of the reason they're not doing too well. And Krontis has an injury. Luckily, he's not really a first team regular, but it's never nice to see players constantly getting injured. Knas Mulner will come on for him. And we have a free kick. Mantelos to Cialis, and it's 4-0. Well done, lads. I've only just noticed that Platanias have 4 clear-cut chances. I haven't seen any of them. I guess it's all those times that Torres was put through one-on-one and just messed it up. Oh, well. We've taken full advantage, if we're being honest. It's a corner. Can we make it 5? Yes, we can. Cialis, 5-0. Perfect response to that midweek defeat. Aravidis picks it up. Can we have another just bafflingly intense period of play where we just bag loads of goals? Well, maybe not. Teta wins the ball. And it's Garcia to Cristina Aguilera. Kolovestios covers well. And Anistis can launch the ball up from the goal kick. If he so chooses. And he does choose to do that. And now they can build an attack. Garcia's put through one-on-one, rounds the keeper for a consolation goal. Aguilera has it in the middle. It's Garcia now to Teta. Fantas, another consolation. 5-2. Bit annoyed at our defending here. It's sort of collapsed. But to be honest, it's not going to affect the result one tiny bit. We're getting the 3 points here. It's just a shame that PAOK didn't lose. They've made it 3, so there's no way back for Agatelis now. I don't think they had anything to play for anyway. But that's full time for the domestic season, and we have finished a fairly respectable 5th place. So that's how the season ended. 5th place. I said I'd be happy with that, so I'm going to force myself to be. Olympiacos win the league in the end at a canter. They won their last game 5-0. Lamia and OFI going down. Lamia having come straight back down, having been promoted the season before. They went down with a whimper as well. 5-1 defeat against Tripolis. Anyway, this is how the playoff is going to look. It's actually quite different to what I thought. It's just going to be a mini league system. The team that finished second have 2 points to start with. The team that finished third have 1. So there was actually no benefit at all to finishing fourth. Apart from it just looks a bit better on your CV. It looks like it's home and away round robin. So I don't know what I'll do. I think if I'm still in it at the Tripolis game, if there's still a slight chance of getting a European place, then I will live come the last 2. But if not, then I'll come back at the end of the playoff. Sort of see where we ended up. And look forward to next season. That's going to be it for this extra long episode at the end of the domestic season. There's been heartbreak. There's been plenty of goals. There's been wonderful performances. But a tinge of disappointment at the end. But we're not going to get too downbeat because we've got a playoff to finish third in. All right, guys, just a quick little update on the save. I've played through the European Places playoff. It turns out the winners of the playoff go into the Champions League, and the remaining teams go into the Europa League. The team who finishes last in the playoff presumably loses that Europa League spot if a team that finished below them win the cup, as would happen in any other league. I'll show you the league, how the playoff actually went down. We got absolutely battered. We're just clearly far, far out of our depth at this level, and that's annoying because that's the level I want to be competing at. In fact, it was such a disappointing sort of return from those six games that I had this board meeting to discuss my future, and I was set a points target. So if I don't pick up, I think it's 10 points in the next five games, which is definitely doable as long as we go, as long as we don't get a ridiculous start. I'd like to not have any Athens derbies in the first five games. Then it should be manageable, and I should have the opportunity to sort this mess that I've created out. It does mean that this could be the end of the series, though, if I don't actually meet that points target, which will be kind of embarrassing. But I will boot up a new save and get a new series out there as soon as possible if this one does go down the toilet. Anyway, that's it for this season, guys. I'll see you in the next part for the start of the next season. Take care. See ya.